Hi all, this is the MakeHaven instructional video for the Arbor press. Effectively, this tool is just meant for pushing really hard. So you can use it for a wide variety of tasks. Some people would make a CNC metal embossing tool, and then if you made a leather product, you could push it into the leather to emboss, or into wood, or into metal if you had steel going into aluminum or something like that. You can use it with dies. So a die would be an outside shape of metal and then an inside shape, and then you put something in between it, plastic, wood, leather, sheet metal, and then you just push down and it takes that inner die and punches it through, so you can make a whole bunch of those shapes quickly. It could be used for pushing bearings into a housing. It could be used for a large number of tasks where you want to apply a whole lot of force in a somewhat controlled downward orientation. So there aren't too many parts to it. You can go over them. This crank is what you use just to raise and lower. So for yucks, we'll just have this, and we can move. We'll put this on here and just lower it down to the surface. And then we'll engage the ratcheting lever. And so now, before, where we were just raising and lowering this by hand, we have this. This is actually applying the force. So you use this and push down. And then this is now disengaged. And we can lift this back up. So this is just applying friction, so we can just loosen that a little bit to make it easier to lift this back up. You want it, so if you loosen this a whole lot, then it can just go down on its own, which might be what you want, but if you want it a little more firm, then you can just tighten this back up. So it has all of this depth, because let's say you had something really tall, then you might want to put it down here, and then apply the force from the top. Something shallower you can rest up here. This is a big block that you can put on, and let's say you had a pin and you wanted to be able to go through here, one of these other sizes of cutouts. It's just a general accessory. There's not too much. Maybe just if you get a close up on here, then you can see exactly how this mechanism works. So when it's up, this pin, it's not engaged, it's not doing anything. So you can just go up and down. And then when you pull it down, that's when it drops down here and engages. And so then you're actively using this long lever arm. You can see that people really wailed on this because it's bent a little bit. Someone was really pulling to try to get a lot of force out of it. And that's about all there is to it. Yeah, I think you can get pretty creative with how you want to use it. It's a pretty useful tool. One tool that can be used sort of as the opposite of it, just in case you're interested, is a tool called a bearing puller. Sometimes they're used sort of in opposition to each other. So just so you know that this is here, this has sort of a claw that reaches down and can be used to pull things off of an arbor. So it's sort of like the opposite of an arbor press. So this is just the assembled bearing puller. As you might be able to imagine, if you know what a bearing looks like on an arbor is just a shaft that something is mounted onto. So for example, in the table saw, there's an arbor that the blade mounts onto. The arbor press is often used to push, say, bearings onto an arbor coming out of. If you have a motor, there's an arbor coming out and then a pulley wheel on the end of it. And if you have bearings on that, you press those bearings on so they're really firmly on there. To get it off can be really hard. So these teeth sit on the back side of the bearing, and then you turn this with a wrench on the back side and it just slowly pulls it off. The alternative is finding yourself with a hammer whacking it around the edges and applying force unevenly and it kind of wiggles off. So this is the right tool for that job. So occasionally this is just a day saver, and this is just a smaller version of this same setup. These just pop off like this. So pretty simple tool to use. And work in conjunction with the Arbor Press, which is why I mentioned it here. Thanks for watching.